The Niagara on the Lake Terry Fox Run was once again the recipient of an evening of comedy with Joe Politeri. I caught up with Joe to talk about tonight's event. Both of tonight's shows sold out pretty quick. Are you surprised? Because let's face it, you're not that funny.
Yeah, I think people would buy tickets to like goat races at this point. I think everyone just wants to get out of the house. So the fact that we posted an event, I think people would have bought tickets to see my dad watch Judge Judy in his underwear if it was for the good cause. But yeah, I was surprised at how quickly things sold out. In some respects I was, and in some respects I wasn't, because, you know, as a couple and as a family, we've been dying to go out and experience things as everything opens up a little bit, and of course being cautious and following the rules and all of those things. But it was a pretty quick sellout for this show. Yeah,
tonight's event is to raise money for cancer research. And we raise the money and we give it to the Terry Fox Foundation. And Joe is this amazing citizen of our community who inspires everybody. He is so awesome. He brings out the community. He has the spirit, the compassion, and he's so wonderful. And everybody loves to support him. And he really does. He raises a lot of money for Terry Fox. This community now, it's our 30th year of raising money. We started in 1991, and we have now raised over $1 million. You know, we are a small community, but we have a big heart. People like to support each other, and especially for such a worthwhile cause. We like to support people that are going through cancer, people that have lost the fight, and people that are still fighting. It's just that type of community. We have a big heart here, and everybody gathers together to support it.
What got you involved in the first place?
Well, it started when I'm a classroom teacher and I retired, but while I was at school, I used to teach the children all about Terry Fox. And here's a man who says, like, anything is possible if you try. And he just inspires everybody with who he is as a person. He gives so much courage to each and every one of us, and you learn so many values from Terry Fox. And it was always wonderful to show the children and teach the children, and that's where it starts, because that's what Terry saw. He saw children suffering, and he said, somewhere this hurting has got to stop. And as a result, we are all out here raising money for cancer research, and it keeps gaining momentum year after year after year. His story will stand the test of time. He really is our Canadian hero.
So I got involved with the Terry Fox Foundation at a pretty low point in my life. I was kind of going through a bit of a nervous breakdown, I guess you'd call it. And one of my children was doing a Heritage Fair project on Terry Fox, and of course, so many of us had heard his story, but I just happened to read some of the material that my daughter was sort of assembling for her project. And for whatever reason, in that time when I was worried about a lot of things, I was worried about the economy, and I was worried about our business and the future. I was worried about all these things that I really couldn't control. I just read the story of this person who decided that his fate was out of his control, but his actions and his commitment to make things better wasn't. So it really resonated with me, and it stuck with me. You know, as I got through that, it stuck with me, and then as things got better for every facet of my life, it was even more important to me that I at least be part of spreading this message. There was countless customers who came forth as soon as they heard about the show to donate wine. So places like Pilateri Estates and Riverview and Chateau de Charmes and Peller and Vineland Estates and Palatine and Konzelman and Ferox and Oss Brewery, they all came right away and said, is there anything you need? But then we have a great customer up in Beamsville, Fielding Estates Winery, Heidi and Curtis Fielding. We lent them a tractor. They were in need of a tractor and they wanted to rent one. We just said, just borrow it, and Curtis wanted to do something. So he covered the cost of all the food for tonight, so that 100% of the ticket sales and 100% of the bar sales and 100% of the raffle sales will go towards the Terry Fox Foundation or Team Pilsy tonight. I just wanted to say a huge thanks to the great people at Ravine Winery. The Harbor family are some of the most generous and community-minded people you'll ever meet. When they heard we wanted to do a show, you know, after 18 months of some of the most interrupted and unpredictable revenue that they've ever had in their history here, the first thing they said was, we'd like to volunteer our place. We're going to waive all corkage for tonight so that everything can go to the cause. They're taking care of their staff tonight. And the Harbor family is just a great example of what it means to be part of community here in Niagara.
If people want to contribute, what is the best way to do so?
So if you go to terryfox.org and sponsor a team, you can sponsor Team Pilsy. You'll see us there if you search us. Or you can sponsor Joe Pilateri, Pillitteri. I have to do that everywhere I go. So yeah, you can sponsor Joe Pilateri or Team Pilsy. It all goes to the same team. Any support anyone could give us would be so appreciated.
It's now a virtual run, so that means that you can do the run wherever you want. You can do it around your neighborhood, you can go to a park, you can run, bike, ride, you can do it at any time of the day that you'd like. So we're not gathering as a whole community down in the park, but we're gathering in spirit. I will be down in Simcoe Park, and I will have a display of all the past runs, of pictures of people that have participated. I'll have a banner of Terry Fox. I will still have books and shirts to sell down in the park. And you can come down and make a donation that way if you'd like. Some people will go online to make donations, but you're welcome to come to the park as well.
The run is this Sunday. For more information, don't forget to visit the website. Reporting for The Source, I'm Angie Mendoza.